So in a previous video, we showed that the tail of the turbine is actually wagging the entire turbine. So in this video, we correct that problem, and then we instrumentate the turbine, and we do some serious testing and evaluation. Extra distance from the center of the turbine, maybe eliminate the wagging of the tail. So we've increased the size of the tail sections, hopefully to eliminate the tail wagging the turbine that we observed earlier. And once we get that problem resolved, we'll set up a series of tests to do a proper controlled evaluation of the turbine. So the extra length of the tail arms and the sizes of the tail segments appears as if it's doing a good job in removing or eliminating the tail wagging. So here I've marked the power plate so that I can easily set it to 15 degrees forward, 15 degrees backward to help set it up for our upcoming tests. I have my instrumentation in place. So this test will have the power plate tilted forward about 15 degrees and the yaw is locked in place. Turbine can't yaw. The tail is locked at 0 degrees tilt. So I hope to do a test at 0, 50, and 100% tilt back. I'll be looking while driving at my live view camera right here. So I've created a graphic placed it on the lower left of the screen to show what the orientation configuration of the power plate is with respect to the turbine. The camera angle doesn't really do a very good job of showing where the power plate is located at any given time, so a series of graphics will help show this. Later on, these graphics will be shown in the tables and charts to help analyze what the overall results are. So here the power plate is set to the maximum height or 100%. It's tilted forward 15 degrees, and because it is in front of, directly in front of the top bucket, the anticipation was that this would be the best location for the power plate to control the turbine speed. However, as you will see in a subsequent clip and with the analysis a little bit later on, this particular configuration was not in any way whatsoever capable of controlling the turbine speed. So this configuration of the power plate with respect to the turbine turns out to be the most interesting and also the most unexpected result. If you look at the RPM right now, for example, it's about 80 RPM, and the wind speed is equivalent to 60 some kilometers an hour. The turbine is turning quite slowly compared to other configurations that we tried. So this in essence means that we have potentially an excellent aerodynamic brake that we can make use of in a practical turbine later on as we continue with our experiments. So right now the wind speed is more or less equivalent to about 90 kilometers an hour. The turbine speed is little over 200 RPM. So this means that if we look at a linear relationship, we should be able to go to 160-180 kilometers an hour and still keep the turbine RPM well within the tested speed limits. So in this test run, the power plate is removed from the turbine, and here we want to demonstrate the need to have some means of aerodynamic control over the turbine speed. Otherwise, in extreme wind speeds, the turbine could essentially destroy itself. Also in this clip, you'll see the slow motion version of this video clip. So with the power plate removed from the turbine is rotating without any means of overspeed control, and if you look at the RPM versus the wind speed, you can see that if we increase the wind speed much more, the turbine would overspeed outside of the tested limits in terms of the speed of rotation. Here we have a summary of the test results with the turbine mounted on the pickup truck and set to 7 different configurations. So the chart that we have shows the turbine RPM with the turbine operating at 50 kilometers an hour. There's 7 tables, each representing one of the 7 configurations. Ideally, we would have had more data, but that's what we have at the moment to work with. And as our experiments continue, we'll see what might evolve. So this table summarizes the information that we collected in the 7 tables below. And as an example of the turbine performance, I selected 50 kilometers an hour and used these averages from here across to here to create the table chart. So the configurations are noted right here, and they correspond with the configuration shown in each pair of the chart. So looking at the resulting chart, the first bar shows the turbine without a power plate, no power plate right here. There's nothing to impede the or to enhance or whatever the turbine performance. The second bar shows the turbine with a power plate in place, slanted forward, and as you can see, we're getting a wee bit more RPM from this particular configuration compared to the turbine without the power plate. However, the difference is negligible pretty well. The third bar shows the turbine with the power plate slanted backwards, and in this lower position, the same as right here. And that's what I'm calling 0% in terms of the power plate position and the tail orientation. The fourth bar is the most significant bar, that result that we have from observing the performance up to now. This particular configuration, the power plate is at the midpoint, or 50%. It's slanted forward, and as you can see, the RPM very much lower than all of the other 6 results that we discovered. So if you look at this bar right here and this bar right here, you'll see that the power plate is in the highest position, or 100%, here and here. In this case, it's slanted forward. In this case, it's slanted back. The outputs are not too much different from each other, but the significance of this particular configuration of the power plate with respect to the turbine is that we anticipated originally that with the power plate blocking the flow to the receding bucket right here, this would effectively provide some turbine overspeed control. Turned out that was not the case, at least up to this point with our findings. If we look back down to this result right here with the power plate at 50% slanted forward, you can see that we have excellent aerodynamic braking in this configuration. So what that means is that potentially we can utilize this configuration for normal operating wind speeds of the turbine, and this configuration to control the speed of the turbine when the wind gets higher than we need. So with the turbine operating then with the power plate right here, when the wind speed exceeds set limit, the turbine tail will tip back, move the power plate up to the center point, at which point it would be mechanically stopped. It would stay here until the speed of the wind dropped down, and then the turbine power plate would drop back down to here. So theoretically, at least, it looks as if we can take advantage of this characteristic of the power plate and turbine to hopefully have a practical turbine in terms of operational performance and in aerodynamic overspeed control. So the next clips in the video will show the remaining three configurations that we tested. These configurations are shown already on the chart and the tables. Well, as you can see, this configuration of the power plate and turbine has very little influence on the performance. Likewise with this current configuration, the turbine running with the power plate directly in front of the receding bucket has very little influence on the turbine output, which not something that we anticipated, but it appears to be a fact. And right now we have the turbine set up on a fixed location, and you'll see that at the end of the video. So the power plate now is also at midpoint with respect to the turbine buckets, but the plate is slanted back. And this has very little influence on the turbine output, which is kind of counterintuitive, but that's the results we're getting at the moment. So we now have the wind turbine mounted in a fixed location for the winter months. We have already made a couple of modifications to the turbine to take advantage of the observations we made earlier. Right now the tiltback is limited to 50%, and hopefully this will control the turbine speed. And with a bit of luck, we'll get some high wind speeds during the winter time. Certainly we hope to get wind speeds over 100 kilometers an hour to give this a reasonable test.